southeast tip of North America, on an island called Newfoundland, there's an airport. It used to be one of the biggest airports in the world. And next to it is a town called Gander. Everybody knows everybody else. And everybody in this room has a story about how they started that day.
Welcome to the Rock, if you come from away. You probably understand about half of what we say. They say no man's an island, but an island makes a man.
Especially when one comes from one like Newfoundland.
Welcome to the Rock.
That morning I'm in the classroom. It's our first day back and the school buses are on strike. So I'm covering for Annette, who's running late.
Sorry, Beulah. How's the kids?
Not exactly thrilled to be inside on such a gorgeous day. So I told them we'd only have a half day this morning, and they were quite pleased. Until I told them we'd have the other half in the afternoon.
Welcome to the wildest weather that you've ever heard of.
Where everyone is nicer, but it's never nice above.
Welcome to the farthest place you'll get from Disneyland.
Fish and chips and shipwrecks.
This is Newfoundland.
Welcome to the Rock.
I'm in my car. The kids cross Airport Boulevard to get to school. And that time of day, people are in a little bit of a rush to get to work and stuff. So, normally I sit there and run my radar. And if they're speeding, I'll stop them and write out a warning ticket. I'll write STHD. Slow the hell down.
Welcome to the land where the winters try to kill us and instead
we will not be killed.
Welcome to the land where the waters try to drown us and we said
we will not be drowned.
Welcome to the land where we lost our loved ones and we said
we will still go on.
Welcome to the land where the winds try to blow
and we said no.
That morning I dropped my kids off at school and head to the SPCA where I'm greeted by my other kids all barking and meowing for breakfast and a belly rub. Not that I'm complaining, I love them. But by the time feeding is done, I got to get back to pick up my human kids. So I take just 1 second for myself, and I'm sitting in my car.
I'm in the staff room.
I'm in the library.
And I turn on the radio.
I'm running my radar when Bonnie comes by. She pulls off, and she's waving at me like mad. So I roll down my window, and she says,
Oz, turn on the radio.
Slow it down, Bonnie.
Oz, turn on your radio.
You are here.